Hello, welcome to this session of me painting a portrait. Before I dive into this video, thank you to all my subscribers and all that subscribe. It means so much to have you here. If you've tuned in for the first time, hi, my name is Debbie and I'm a self-taught artist. On my channel, I share my art tips and painting process. The reason I share my art is because when I started painting 7 years back, I found it hard to see representation online, especially with melanin tones. If you love this kind of content, be sure to click that subscribe button and like this video. Back to this painting. I'm painting a portrait of an African lady. She has yellow-brown skin and is smiling. I'll share the process it took me to create and give you the mind behind how I create a portrait. I am using acrylics on A1 size paper. There are two ways I go about with painting a portrait. First, I sketch on canvas. This helps me give a quick result to my painting. Secondly, I start painting straight onto the canvas. This is another method I use, and it's my favorite process of painting as it teaches me so much about the human face anatomy and about painting in general. When painting, I layer so many times, and this helps me bring depth to my pieces and give it rich colors. The first layer, I block in colors with primary colors. Here I use yellow as my brightest tone, red as the mid tone, and blue as my darkest tones or shadows. In my second layer, I blend a similar color to the skin tone. And here, as you can already see, the colors from the primary blocked in colors are seeping through the painting. After I've put in my second layer, I come in with my third layer, which is adding details. And here I make sure that my proportions are right and I work with the shadows as well. The fourth layer is when I add the mid-tones. These are colors between the darkest tones and the brightest tones. When painting, especially when I'm using acrylics, I usually wet my canvas at the back and I wet my brush as I paint. I use a wet brush, which is clean, and I paint over the areas where I'm going to put in my colors. Here, I would add my brightest tones and then come in with the mid-tones. This helps me have a smooth transition, and I could add shadows as well. I make sure that these areas are mildly wet, not too wet or runny, and not too dry. It gives me a very smooth blending. I go back and forth with working on details, proportions, and blending. Here I correct the eyes, the nose, the lips, because as you know, portraits are very unique, and this is one of the struggles you might have when painting a portrait. You have to make sure that you paint the right shape at the right location for you to be able to come up with the right features of that face. Huge pieces like this tend to have issues with proportions. So what I do is I always step away from the painting and view it from afar as often as possible. Here, I am just working with the details of her face. I make sure I look at my reference image as often as possible. This helps me not to paint what I think, but what I see. Now, at this stage, I make sure I blend my colors as smooth as possible. I repainted her eyes as I felt that it needed more attention. Then I went to paint her lips, adding details, shadows, and making sure I got her smile right. The goodness with acrylics is the ability for me to correct errors I missed out and repaint over mistakes I made. I now go in with painting easier features like the head wrap and the shirt. The shirt was actually tricky for me despite how smooth and easy it looks here. Here is a clip of me mixing colors for my background. This part was tricky for me because I was conflicted with what colors and mood to use for my piece. I decided to go with the green grass shown in the reference image. I also didn't know what to do with the flowers that I wanted to add to my background. I had a choice to go realistic or to go abstract. I chose an abstract background because I didn't want the flowers at the back to compete for attention with their portrait. This is how the painting looks, and I love the choice I made with the background. I hope you enjoyed my mini explanation of how I came up with this piece. I loved creating this and it made me happy to see how it came out. So this is it for today. Do like and subscribe, and see you in the next video.